Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, folks. How are you doing today? Michael Zuber, One Rental at a Time. And one of the things I love about the One Rental at a Time channel is I don't just talk about my stuff. A lot of the YouTube channels out there just are based on the creator's knowledge and content. And that's not who I am. I know there's a lot of stuff going on in the real estate investing world that I have zero experience in. And I go find people that have that for you. So when you think of One Rental at a Time, it's not just buy and hold. It's house hacking, it's self-management, it's raising private money, apartments, syndication, flipping, all this stuff. That's why we have the experts that we do. And on Thursdays, we have the three amigos. Matt, how you doing?
I'm doing awesome, Mike. Super excited to be here with you guys.
Thank you. And Dion, how are you?
Howdy, Mike. I'm ready for round three.
Yes, folks. Round one was a discussion about Meet Kevin. You've got to check it out. Make sure that you vote, you vote, you vote if you are a millennial in California. But guys, what I want to talk about here is an area that I have zero experience in, as in never done it, and frankly, never wanted to do it, was happy to pay for it, probably had to given location, but I would not have done it if it was next door. And more importantly, you guys added it to my course. And the first topic today is self-management. And Dion, you are the creator of that bonus section. So we will start with you. Why the hell do you do self-management?
So in the course, that's actually the first video I added. Why do I self-manage? And you and I did a video on my channel that I appreciate you doing where we compared self-managing to have a property manager. And your first few years, you're either managing the tenants or you're managing the property manager. Yours became a lot more hands-off once you learned how to manage the property managers. But no one is going to take care of your property like you do because it's yours. And there are times where I wouldn't self-manage. If I was investing at a distance where yours are, you know, a couple hour drive away, that's a 4 hour turnaround. I would have a property manager in another state, property manager. If I didn't have good people skills, I would definitely have a property manager, but I figured out how to talk to people and I'm more comfortable talking to tenants than I would want a third person. One of the best strategies that I think I've came up with to kind of, you know, self-promote a little bit is the binder strategy. Mm-hmm. Literally getting a tenant to request a rent increase in a longer lease. I wouldn't want to put that in the hands of your property manager and say, hope you get this right. So that's why I do it, is because I have the skills and I'm close enough to manage within, it's a 30 minute drive to my farthest property. And I want to say thanks for asking me to put it or letting me put it in the course, because the highest form of learning is teaching. Mm-hmm. And I learned that making YouTube videos. Every time I go to put out a concept, I want to explain something like, what is the income snowball? Okay, well, there's 3 days of research to make sure I understand how it works and that there's more ways to do it than mine. And I need to explain those. By the time that video is done, that is a concept I'll never forget. So self-managing, making a course step-by-step, the process, to make it as easy as possible, because I'm super lazy and I've got 16 units down to about 2 hours a month.
Wow.
And that's including, I deposit, one tenant still sends a check and I deposit it with an app. That takes 5 minutes. That's logged. For those 2 hours, if it took more time, I wouldn't be motivated to add more units. Mm. And since I have my systems in place, making the video for the course let me refine some that I actually might have just kind of thought, that's how I do it. But when you have to articulate it, it let me put it into clearer terms even for myself. Mm-hmm. So thanks for letting me do that.
Yeah. And again, folks, how to get started one rental at a time is a course I created because people asked, how'd you do it? Right? You worked full time, you built a portfolio. How'd you do it? How do you compare deals? But that's only my story. So coming to someone like Dion who does self-management, which again, I've never done. And as I've said, don't want to do. It's great because a lot of people that buy my course want to self-manage. A lot of them are 30 minutes away. A lot of them are people, they can talk to people. So I can't thank you enough. I could never create a self-management section. I could be like other channels and go read about it, go read Brandon Turner's book and then, you know, regurgitate whatever I read from that, but that's not who I am. That's not what I'm going to do. So having you as an expert there to create that is great. And let's not forget, folks, we are going to be putting the binder strategy off an actual property in the course. I saw the binder last week. That video is coming, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Now that I have the actual data, just yes, the video's done. No.
Oh, it is. Oh,
wow. I wanted the actual numbers of from what the property cost, what mm-hmm. my payment is, what the tenants are paying, That's how awesome. The conversations went, some things the tenant said during the meeting of the binder that made the meeting easier. Yes. And I'm glad I'm putting it in your course because I don't want to put that on my channel because those tenants are and I'm as transparent as I can be, but you'll see when I have the video in the course that I literally say the tenant said this, which made it easier for me to get a higher rent request from the tenant.
Yeah. It's going to be awesome. So folks, the self-management section has been there for about 8 weeks or so. We are going to be adding the binder strategy over the next couple of weeks, or the binder video. And just so we know, Dion, you've had other ideas on content you want to create. So whenever those come out, we will load them in the course. No extra charge. We just add more and more and more bonus content. But Matt, you also self-manage. And
I do.
Your portfolio is a little bit bigger.
It is.
So why the hell do you self-manage and what the heck?
I don't have people skills unless you include sarcasm. Unless you include sarcasm,
that's a people skill. That's not a people skill.
Yeah. I don't know. I seem to think it is. yeah. I mean, honestly, the biggest reason for me was I knew how to fix things and I was too cheap. You know, I talked to a couple firms and they were like, yeah, you know, we're 8% if nothing happens. And I was like, wait, you get 8% for nothing? Yeah. Take a flying leap, pal. That's not how my world works. I get 8% for something. 8% so I can pick up the phone. Yeah. Hard pass. Yeah. Nope. So, yeah. And then the other thing too, is I wanted to control my own properties, know what was going on in mine, because my path was a little bit different than Dion's, because yes, I self-managed, but every property that I bought was a turd. Mm. I bought garbage and I completely redid it. And everything, I knew where everything was in the walls. I knew how everything was done. I knew all the product that we used. I know how everything was set up. I know how the wires were run for the different rooms. I knew all of that stuff. And so for me, it was very, very, very inexpensive for me once I rehabbed the entire unit to then self-manage, because, you know, we would count the number of calls or texts that we would get over the first year. And after the first 30 days that somebody would live there, it would usually be two or three the rest of the year. Yeah. It would be a complete non-factor. And so that's what allowed us to get to, you know, 70-ish units, is because we would redo them before we'd let people move in. That way we knew what we were handing over was brand spanking new and in good shape and ready to go. Mm-hmm. And when we started adding more units towards the end, we started not gutting and rehabbing, but just kind of, you know, generally going through them, we see more calls from those units because we're taking over things that we didn't necessarily do, but that's okay. So far, so good.
Yeah. I think I read somewhere that self-managed mom and pop landlords, about 67% self-managed. So I'm definitely in the minority. You guys are in the majority. I am so happy that both of you have added content where I have no experience, because the course would not be as good, right? I can help you compare deals. I can help you understand yield. I can help you grow a network, but I am not the guy to help self-manage. I am not the guy to have a discussion on rent and have the tenant ask for a rent increase. That is clearly Dion in the binder strategy. So guys, thank you so much for this. If you are thinking about self-management, believe me, it's in the course and it's coming from experts like Dion and Matt. So Dion, how can people find you, be part of your world?
Right here on YouTube, Dion Talk Financial Freedom. I'm pretty active in the Bigger Pockets community and the official Bigger Pockets Facebook group and the Real Estate Rookie group. I'm actually helping out with a 12-week boot camp with Bigger Pockets starting August 24th. I try to answer every question that comes my way.
Awesome. And Matt?
LumberjackLandlord.com, Lumberjack Landlord on YouTube. How to get one rental at a time, and part of that with the Hackology, which we'll be covering in this next segment.
There you go. Well, guys, thank you very much for this. This is always a lot of fun. I love the three amigos on Thursday. Bye.